The gaming is upon us once again. It is Friday once again. And with that, I'd like to welcome you to yet another Friday stream. We're going to be doing Nintendo Switch demos. And there's a game. It's on a computer. It's called Guilt Gear. Yeah, I like Metal Gear, but what makes those gears so guilty anyways? Like, what'd they do? Are they, like, paying for their crimes in Metal Gear? I don't know. All I know is that isn't there a bear? Or no, that's Tekken. That's Tekken. There's no bears in Guilty Gear, I think. But anyways, welcome to the stream. I hope you're all doing well. If you're new to the stream, this is Demo Showcase, where I play a collection of Nintendo Switch or otherwise demos. This time we're doing Switch demos, as you can see with your eyes. I don't know which ones I'm going to be doing before going into the show. I just kind of download a bunch that maybe look interesting. And then as I go through, I decide to pick one. And I think we're going to start with Emio, the smiling man. Now, I probably won't be doing too much of this because I hear there's actually a lot in this demo. And not only that, my voice is still recovering from yesterday's Undertale stream. So this is probably a mistake, but I'm going to do it anyways because I don't know why. But apparently this game is, like, surprisingly good and has indoctrinated a lot of people to be Famicom Detective Club fans. I've never played any of these games. And truth be told, I don't even really know what these were until they started appearing in Nintendo Directs. So, settings. Let's start with that. Volume good? Looks like it's a little loud. I can turn it down slightly. Auto save settings. Messages skipped in skip mode. Oh man, if the voice acting's done for me, that would be amazing. Sure. I guess I'll keep most of this normal. Display speed fast. Highlight terms. Protagonist voice. Yes. Yes. Give me voice. Thank you. Wait, is it only the protagonist that's voice? What is that, actually? Turn those voices up. That's usually about what I do. BGM at default, SFX a little down, voice all the way up. If my ears are gone, that's part of the plan. All right. Well, let's begin. If the voice acting's done for me, that would be amazing. All names, characters, businesses, places, events, and incident in this game are fictitious. Any resemblance to any actual persons is merely a coincidence. Oh, it's Japanese voice acting. I guess I should have known that. Okay. Well, I'll do this the exact same way I do Yakuza voice acting, which is, I don't. They're doing the voices for me. I'll just go ahead and read it. This might not be the most interesting game for a demo showcase, but I figured we could play this for 20-30 minutes. See if the game gets any good right away.
Yeah, ohayo.
Hello? Okay, so it's all voiced. Very good. I wonder if there's auto-advancing text. That's not it. It's nice that you can do that, though. You can review things that they've said. In case you're forgetful like I am.
Yakuza's
looking a little different.
Sensei.
I seem to be a lot younger. and a lot less in trouble with the government. Currently. That's the smiling man. The boss is the smiling man. Of course. All I know about this is the premise of the game is there's a series of murders done by a masked man with a bag over his head. He's called the Smiling Man. And the point of the game is discovering who is the Smiling Man. So every time we meet a new character, I have to assume that they are the Smiling Man. Hello. It's kind of cool to play a Phoenix Wright-like game and it be a lot more like animated than Phoenix Wright. I mean, not that Phoenix Wright isn't animated, but this feels more animated than that. Let's think. All right, we're done thinking. I am overthinking! An anonymous tip. You keep asking and listening. And let me guess, if you think in between things, he'll comment on it. Yeah, I guess so. Call, engage. Yeah, get over here.
Alright.
Continue to speak with him then.
No ID.
How died? Strangled? The hash spring? Bash? Sting? Oh, shut up now. Music's nice. I'm immediately engaged with the music. I like that that stanky guitar. He's thinking about it. Now we call. Okay, no.
So you're
gonna have to like press some of these buttons multiple times.
Other
observation, you say? Yes? Look at that guy with the... He's testing the fingerprints back there. I only know what that is because of Phoenix Wright. I would have never known that a policeman could ever do that. Am I allowed to just do that? Claire? First police officer. Look at you. Look at that bicycle! Alright. I'm going to assume Sasaki is the victim. Or this is just garbage.
Fancy thing.
That's dirt. Wow. Holy fucking shit, dirt. Forensics expert. Fingerprints. See, I know. Those are trees. That's the sky! Very observant of you. Now tell me about this grass. Yes! I wonder how much of this is relevant, whereas it's just like, yeah, you could look at this dude if you want. Yeah. Okay. Let's look at the victim. Am I a detective or what am I exactly? That's illegal, sir.
いいんですか?
Thank you. Very nice, officer, for you to break the law like that.
Uh-oh.
Detective Kuze. Another parallel to Yakuza. I see.
Matte,
yeah,
so
we shouldn't be standing in the road. It's not safe. You could get run over. Enter your first name. Oh, you know me. Ground. Enter your last name. Dead. Grounded. My name is Ground Dead.
Tante?
Yeah. One thing at a time here. Think. How do I answer the question? How? I can't think. I can look. I can examine. What? Well? Hello? Well? Why'd she do that again? How do I fucking answer the question? Thanks for stating that. I already understood that, though.
Kuze-kun,
you are already the smiling man. Oh my god, you have a wide head. Why do these characters animate like VTubers? Not that I'm complaining necessarily, it's just really weird to see in a game like this. Like, they face forward and then, like, slightly tilt to the left and right.
うつぎさんとは古い付き合いでな、ちょっと思うところがあって来てもらったのじゃが。はじめまして、うつぎです。お仕事の邪魔をして申し訳ありません。どうも、クゼです。 失礼ですが、どこかでお目にかかりませんでしたか?
いえ、私立探偵に知り合いはおりません。
You're acting shady. It is you!
鎌田警部、 私は現場に戻ります。失礼します。
Goodbye。Hey, Mr. Usugi.
先生とは事務所に戻ってから話せばいい。
Oh, damn. About cruising.
驚いたじゃろ。
Dead.
クゼ君は優秀なのじゃな。
Right, they refer
to me by my last name. 少し真面目すぎるというか、自他ともに対して厳しいところもあっての。
That person struggled with the camera back there.What are these tires?
いえ、僕なら大丈夫です。
神、あんた今何時だと思ってるのよ。
God?
ありゃりゃ、また始まったか。まだ中学生か。かわいそうにな。
また始まったって。
あれじゃ。
OK。
すみません、先輩。昨日ちょっと用事で遅くなって。
言い訳はいいの。どうせまた飲みすぎたとかなんでしょ。だいたいあんたはいつも。
勘弁してくださいよ、先輩。
やれやれ。
やれやれ。What in the name of JoJo's bizarre adventure is going on here? Can I just look at the body, please?
いつものことなんじゃ。気にせんで。
あの男の刑事さん、なんだかかわいそう。
Let me...
すまんが、それは無理な話やの。
Oh, shit. Not allowed.
男の刑事が…クゼ刑事に怒られている。
Okay. Allow me to observe. Camera!
不法的
だが、Camera!
手がかりを見つけ出そうとしているように見える。
Yeah, okay.
先生とは事務所に戻ってから話せばいい。
Then do it. What? Where's my UI? Where's my UI? What's my UI doing?All right.
今呼んだら僕まで怒る。
Do it anyways.
しかし今日のクゼ君はやけに厳しいの。不機嫌なんじゃろか。ふん。ふん。
ふん。
ふん。
Do it again. One more time.
ふん。
Yeah. yeah.
男の刑事が。
Do I need to spend some time thinking? I'm not sure how I feel about this UI.
そういえば、さっきの警官、被害者の様子が異様だったと言っていたな。
それにしても今日はやけに。
被害者は発見された時、異様な様子だったと聞いたのですが。
ああ、その通りじゃ。だから、宇津木さんに来てもらったんじゃよ。
どういうことなんだろう。
どんな様子か気になるじゃろ。君にも見せてやりたいところなのんじゃが。あの、仏さんは、ついさっき移送されて、ここにはもうないのじゃよ。もっとも、君が調べるのはクゼ君が許さんじゃろうな。常識的に考えれば彼女が正しいわの。
確かにそうですよね。
でもまあこれくらいは構わんじゃろ。
They translated a lot of words into just yeah.
これが発見された時の仏さんの姿なんじゃ。
I am the big man.
とりあえず我々は引き上げよう。
Stop calling me
that.
こちらから声をかけといて、君や宇津木さんに申し訳ないことをしたの。
いいえ。ではまた後ほど。
The bag man. Rubber band man. Definitely looks like they were strangled around the neck, though, at the very least. Cry. I could do this effect with my soundboard as well. That was the smiling man, I guess. Like I said, I could keep going with this demo. Obviously, there's a certain amount of it where, you know, I could keep playing for a while to really get hooked into the story. But I'm going to call it there since it is just a visual novel. There's not really much to really do gameplay-wise. But there's your hook, if you're at all interested. Yeah, I don't know how I feel about it right away. At least first impressions didn't make me be like, oh, I really need to play this. I find it really weird that the characters animate like VTubers and that the UI seemed a little... It was like hard to figure out like where, like what action I needed to do. I mean, I guess that's true in Phoenix Wright as well, but I don't know. It just seemed a little arbitrary. So, there you go. That's Emio, I guess. Let's go ahead and move on to something else, I guess. Let's do Picross. Sure. This one's been sitting on my Switch for a while. Obviously, you can see I've downloaded a few more demos since last time. The Nintendo Switch itself is just a never-ending pool of demos. Whereas on Steam, it's like practically impossible to find games that have demos without outwardly searching for the individual games. Switch is just like, bam, you go to eShop, you search, you hit the tab that says games with demo, and then there you go. You get literally every option on the eShop. So I've never played Picross before. We'll try normal Picross. Let's start by going over the Picross rules and some tips and a tutorial. Do you want to view the tutorial? Yes. I think this game is just Sudoku, but I don't know. Let's see. Let's look at some Picross basics. We'll be using this puzzle as an example. In Picross, you must use the hints displayed on the top and left side of the puzzle to fill in the squares. These hints show the number of connected squares for that row or column. So the two squares here are connected to the four squares in this row. When there are multiple numbers like 3, 1, there will always be a gap in the squares represented by each. I thought there was going to be 31. I was like, there seems to be a little less than 31 there, but... To reveal the hidden picture, use the hints to fill in the correct squares. I know there's like... What is that, a bird? I don't know. I know there's like Mario Picross, there's like Twilight Princess Picross on 3DS. Also, this game is loud as shit, I'm gonna turn it down some more. I think there's like Picross on... on like NSO for like N64 or Super Nintendo or something. Like Mario's Picross or something. Let's start here. As this is a 5x5 puzzle, this hint means the whole column should be filled in. Have a go! You already showed me the puzzle. Well done. Next, let's look at this row. 3-1 line has 3 connected squares and 1 isolated square. There's at least 1 empty square between them. Try filling in this line. Good. That's correct. We don't need to fill in this leftover square. Anyways, put an X on squares that you're certain about not filling in.
Bye, bye, bye.
Good. Next, let's look at this row. Since there's already a square filled in, there are only 2 ways this line can be finished. We don't know which way is correct. Yes, I do. But we know the corner squares are empty. So let's place an X over the corner squares. But how do we know that? Oh, this one makes sense. Well done. Since we know the X goes here, you can find the correct square in this column. Right, because they're connected. They would have to be. Okay. Correct. All the squares for this column are filled in. Remember to put an X on empty squares. You really have to? Wouldn't just filling in the art be good enough? Let's look at this column. This is like showing your work in math. It's like, I don't want to do that. Just let me show you the correct answer. There's 1 open square at the top, but our hint number is 2. So we know that it won't fit there. Put an X on squares that don't need to be filled in. Don't touch that for now. I've already got this shit figured out. The correct squares for the hint 2 are hidden in the column of the bottom 3 squares. Since the hint is for 2, there are only 2 ways to fill in these squares. You see it? The middle square is used for both, so let's fill it in. Well done. This trick will come in handy on many puzzles. Have a look at these examples. If you think about it carefully, it's always possible to find the correct pattern. Always. Try out all the patterns to find correct squares, even on lines with lots of hint numbers. Right? I kind of wish they didn't show me the solution to this, because it's not letting my brain take the moment to figure it out. You're almost there. Go ahead and complete the puzzle. Where could it possibly be? What is that? It is a bird! That wasn't blue a moment ago, but now it's blue. It's all for an explanation of Picross basic rules and techniques. Alright, cool. So now I understand Picross, conceptually. Select the input method used during puzzles. Buttons. I'm playing on a console, so buttons is what I do. Use the hint roulette. Now, see if I can't figure this out.
Well, we know for sure that that's gonna be like that, okay? And it's gonna be a 2 and a 2. So we got a. Probably gonna be.
Well, we know for sure it'll be that. Those 3. Don't know where this will be just yet. It'll be a 1 and then a 2. Maybe 2 and 2. And then 3. 3. An incorrect square has been fixed automatically. You can adjust this option from the options. You can also turn it off. Turn autocorrect off. Yes. Let me make mistakes. There, it's wrong. All right. So, we've got 1 and 1 over here. We've got 1 and 2. Okay. Well then, that would have to be it. Yes. What am I looking at? What? Mount? Oh. I was looking at the contrast. I was looking at like the bright colors, and I thought the gray was the background. I was like, what am I looking? It looked like a dude juggling, like, vaguely. Oh, you have to actually buy Picross if you want to play more of that. Okay. Mega Picross is harder than normal Picross. Okay. I'm assuming it's just bigger, right? No, I don't want to. I think I figured it out. Maybe we should review the tutorial. For me. You know what? No, we'll figure it out. We got there. So I'm assuming it just means within this group are three. It seems like it'll be there. It'll for sure be there. We got two and three. I don't know what the three means. Does this mean that in this group, there's only five total? Like within this, so we've got four already, meaning one, two, three. That can't be right. Get it? No. It's two in a row. But there's nothing on this row. So that means what? Like, there's no numbers on either there. Well, we know for sure that this one is right, despite there not being a number there. So it's not like that there aren't tiles there. Okay. What? When it goes black, what does that mean? Just start placing them around. Wait, that's more than two. Oh, shit. That's more than one. Oh, fuck. Well, this one has to be here, right? There's no going around that. Oh, this is like big brain shit. I really should have, checked mistakes. No mistakes found. Okay, so far everything's right. I'm assuming I'm assuming the black means what? That I had it wrong. I got it. It's the mouse again. Wait, is the puzzle just gonna be the mouse every time? Color Picross. It's harder than normal Picross. Mm-hmm. Yes, show me that there tutorial. I'm gonna need it. Alright, let's go over the basics of Color Picross. This guide is aimed at users who know the rules for and how to solve normal Picross battles. For those unfamiliar with Picross, please start with the normal Picross tutorial first. Use this puzzle as an example. Thanks for solving it for me. For the most part, the rules are the same as normal Picross. These hits show the numbers of connected squares for that line. In Color Picross, the hint's color responds to the color of the connected squares. For example, in this line, we can see that from left to right, there are three connected squares and three brown connected squares. Or three white, I just skipped that word for some reason. There's one brown square, three white connected squares, and three green connected squares. Okay. Did you notice in color Picross, hint numbers won't always have empty squares between them. But hint numbers are different colors. There doesn't need to be a space between each group of correct squares. That being said, when colors of hint numbers are the same, there will always be an empty space between correct squares, just like a normal Picross. Always remember that in color Picross, when the color of hint numbers are different, there may not be an empty space between correct squares. All right. I'm going to end tutorial there and figure out the puzzle on my own. I just needed the general breakdown of how it worked. Let's see what the hint roulette does. Show me the one where it's super obvious, the five across. All right. So we got one, and then we got one. Okay. We got one, two. One. I gotta figure out how to switch colors. Okay, there you go. One. I did it. I guess. What is that? Oh, it's a man. It's Scott Cawthorn. Bodybuilder. Yeah, it sure is. It sure is a bodybuilder. Uh-huh. Oh, this one has multiple. Oh shit, this one's massive. Sure, hit roulette. Great. Alright, well, it's something to start with, at least. Alright, so we know that. We know that there is no pink in the first one. But there is pink here. 12 across. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. Very good. And then there's three groups of three here. Two, two, two. And then another group of three. I'm assuming there. Okay, that's the three. And somewhere else is a two. Presumably here. Okay. We've got another group of three here and a group of three there. And there's somewhere else is another group of two. There, maybe. And a group of four. Okay. It's starting to make sense to me. I think I'm getting it a little bit. So on this one, there's a two somewhere. On one of them. That could be anywhere, right? No. That can't be right. There needs to be 2, 1, and then another 2. Oh god. Oh god. The brain. That would solve that.
Oh god. Oh no. Oh no. What is my brain? Oh.
Let's start somewhere else. We got a 7 down. Right? One of those has to be there. Right? We know that that's there.
One, two, three, four, five, six,
seven. Pink. Two. No. There is no tan in that tile right there. There's a brown somewhere here. It's gotta be here. Presumably here. And then it's a brown there. And a brown there. Why didn't that clear the one? Also, this pink does not exist there, no. There is... What if we take that away, right? And then... One, two, three... Right? There is a tan here. I don't know if this is interesting at all to watch. Probably not. But it is actually interesting to solve. I've never really played a game like this before. Still trying to figure out. There's two pinks down here. Right? One of them goes here. A 3 and then a 2. Well, hang on. This one. That's gotta be like that. If we know definitively, because of the hint, that this line exists, then this either has to be here or here. And there is a space. So this pink, I think, is correct. There is one pink here, however, though. What if it was like that? Yeah? And we just kind of mirror that shape right there. Is this supposed to be, like, identical on both sides? No, I don't think so. We know definitively. I want to say that these probably mirror each other. I don't know what the shape... I don't know what we're making exactly, but... Two here. Okay, and then we need 4 and 4. Like that, baby. Well, I know that that's not right, because that is that the game gave me that, right? I don't know. Don't fucking know. Also, we're wrong here. We got 2. Oh, wait. What the hell? Maybe like this? It's a group of 3. Is this like a fucking, like, child? It looks like I'm making like a baby. a baby. 7 across here. There's 1, 3, 1. So when you highlight this, it actually shows you what numbers you're like in the middle of here. So another 2 there. Yeah. Wait, why is that wrong? 2, 3, 2. Oh. That could be right. Oh no, 1 goes here. Okay. It's got like a milk bottle. Okay. There's another 2 pinker here. Okay. Okay, the 2 pinker has been discovered. Don't know what the fuck is happening beneath this baby. Wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wait. Put that there, and then baby hair goes there. And then it's 3. Okay, wait, hang on. There is a brown here. And then that's full baby foot. I did it. Again, showing your work with the crosses is stupid. I don't like that. Baby! Okay. I eventually got it without even having to really rely on hints other than the starting line. That's a very helpful feature. I like starting with the hint. Wait, did the other ones have extras as well? Oh, it did. Hang on, what about in regular Picross? Yes, there were. Oh, wow, there's more to this than I thought. Recommend viewing the following tutorial for techniques on how to solve difficult puzzles. No. I just did one. I think I can figure it out. I think I like the color Picross the most so far. Alright. That's pretty helpful, actually. So we know definitively out of those what we're working with. We got 1 here, so there's a space. We don't know which 1 this was, though, but I'm going to assume. Three, 1. Well, that's our 1 then. This is gonna be a 2. And then this will be a 3. An 8 here. But wait, there's more. There has to be a space for there to be 8 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8. But we know that this is part of the 8. That is likely. This is wrong. That's the 1. And then there's a 2. two here. That. Wait, no, that couldn't work because this has to be a three. But that's one. So wait, where does this go? Huh? Am I reading the numbers backwards? Unless that's not part of the eight. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's just not part of the eight right there. And then our two is part of that. There's two there. You know that. There's a one there. Okay, so this is part of our two. If that is where that goes, we don't know that yet. Four, and then two. We don't know which one this is yet. There needs to be a connection here. Not there though, because that's a one. So here is a connection, and then that'll be our three, and then one and one. Okay. And then we have a two and a three. That's our three, two, one, and then a two. There's our two. There will be a three later. That's part of it. Part of the three, part of that four. There's one, one. One. Wait, no, that's... I'm doing it wrong. Is it... So this is 2, 1, 2. This is 2, 2, 2. Okay. That checks out. So we got 2, 1. Yeah. I don't know what I... Oh, it's a travel clef on its side. You got a clip. You got a clip Picross piece. I don't know what that means, but okay. Oh, I could absolutely see myself getting addicted to this. I don't think this is good stream material at all. But it is very fun and addictive. Clip Picross. What is this? In this mode, solve multiple Picross puzzles to complete a larger picture. Puzzles have been divided into piece puzzles. Piece puzzles can be solved in the same way as normal Picross puzzles. All of the piece puzzles start off locked. Okay. Let's see. Sure. Oh God, no, these are big. I think I'll pass on doing that. I want to do one more color Picross. And then we'll call it there. Oh God, it's massive. Okay, hit me up with that hit roulette. Okay, it's a great place to start. All right, so it's Sonic the Hedgehog. All right, so what do we got connecting here? We know this is a one. It's part of our twos. This is part of a three. Looks like it'll go up from here. This is part of a two. That's our second two. This is part of a three. Part of a two. It's hard to show you where I'm looking at these numbers here, but you'll just have to take my word for it. This is part of a three. I'm assuming it's going down. This is part of a four. Seems like it's doing that. And that's a two. And then there's... that's the one, so there's no more blue, at least until over here. There is one blue here. One blue there. Wait, no. No blues there. There's a blue somewhere above here. Okay, that's a four, just like that. We got a 10, right? There it is, a 10. Yeah. And there's a blue. Blue. Wait, this 10 isn't showing on the bottom. Meaning it's wrong? Meaning that 10 is not there. Fake tan. The one is associated here, I guess. Four across. I wonder how, like, coding a thing like this would work, because what I find interesting is when you're highlighting the group, it correctly highlights there, right? But notice how when I highlight this one, it highlights the one at the top, but it doesn't highlight a one on... it highlights one horizontally, but not one vertically. Meaning this is wrong, I am assuming. But wait, this is also not getting highlighted. That's getting highlighted. This is not. That's correct. But where else would this go? Because there's a one, and then there's two. Maybe it's just not highlighting because the whole picture isn't done on that row. I don't know. I don't know. I had to guess. It looks like they're doing that again here. Oh, now it's highlighting. Okay. That's what it was missing. It was just the puzzle being complete. Complete. Total annihilation. There's one there. Oh, that fucked everything up, though. Don't do that. That can't be right. Okay. There's an eight across in the middle of this. Is that just 1, 2, 3, 4? It's just right there. Okay. That makes that simple. And then a two and a two. Literally this whole row. Right? And then 1, 2, 3. And then a five here. Presumably, anyways. Okay, so then we got a three connecting with another three here. Gotta be that. Now where does this, I guess there? It's a two. Mama! It's gotta be our six right there. Okay, and then that will connect there, which is a 3 down. And then we got another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Followed by a 1. And then we got a 1. No, that's right. 2 there. Yep, that checks out. And then there needs to be brown. Or whatever that is. I don't know what I'm making yet. I can't really see it. It's not a puppy, though. That much I know for certain. I'm going to assume. What did I fuck up? There. So this is a 1, a 4, and then a 1, and then this one is a 1, a 2, and a 1. Excuse me. Like that. There's 1 blue here. Excuse me. It's a 3 across. And then a 2 across. Okay. Well, I still don't know what I'm looking at. What is that? Fortune teller? Oh, okay. I can kind of see it now. It's very, like... Yeah, when you have it zoomed out like that, it's easier to tell what it is. But when you're really zoomed into the pixels, you're like, huh? Okay. Play large Picross puzzles in this bonus mode. Oh, there's Picross 4 stuff. Oh, shit. Well, that's, I'm gonna call it there for Picross 9. That is a very fascinating game concept. Again, probably boring as shit to watch. Considering literally no viewers right now. But, like, holy shit. That was fun as shit to play, actually. So, alright. What else will we do? I'm not going to be going too terribly late with this tonight. I will be doing Guilty Gear, as I've mentioned before. So, we won't be playing too late. How about... we do Neo, The World Ends With You. We're just kind of boring after boring here. But stuff that I'm interested in anyways. This is another one where it's like this demo has been sitting on my Switch screen for fucking years. Ever since I made this stream segment. This was one of the first demos I ever downloaded. And then I just didn't play it until now. But I've been interested in this series. The friend who once introduced me to Xenoblade said good things about this. But will it work my brain like Picross does? That I don't know. And... do not quit the game or turn off the Nintendo Switch. Okay. This game uses an autosave feature. Holy shit. This demo version features the following restrictions. Max out at level 15. You can only own up to 10 copies of the same pin. I don't know what that means. Okay. Wow. Was this done by the Kingdom Hearts artist Nomura? It looks like Nomura art. It's funky though. Now, I've always been frightened to actually cover this game on my stream, or even the demo, because I heard when it came out that Square Enix were being very rude by just, like, absolutely nuking anyone who's ever streamed this game. I wonder if they're still doing that, you know, 4 years later.
Plain English.
Sorry. I like to understand what they're saying just by listening. Even if the dub is bad, I will prefer an English dub just because it allows me to zone out a little, but still get the information that I need. I do that a lot with games. I just kind of like space out, but then like I'll later catch up in my brain. And be like, ah, yes, I'll process all these words all at once. Which is also why some story details go right over my head. Because I wasn't paying enough attention. But my brain can only be so stimulated. Oh my god, they got the Shibuya 104 building from Persona in this game? No fucking way. No, however will they make Persona 5 sequels now? Well, Jet Set Radio graphics. Yes, but how do I get the numbers to connect to make a baby? So if I'm not mistaken, this is either a remake of a DS game or it's a follow-up to a DS game. I think this is the remake. But didn't they come out with a sequel game? See you at the scramble, dude. The crossing. Oh shit, he at the crossing. Hey. Where are you? This is Jet Set Radio music. What the fuck? You can't say that! Wonderful. Get it? What are these fucking emotes? Me in the Twitch chat, please and thank you. Don't you feel hip? Right. Knowing. Oh god.
What a foe it is then.
Voice acting! Holy shit! I was gonna say, don't you feel hip for understanding, like, text lingo? Cause I don't! I have no idea what they just said! Help! Anyways, investigate icons you spot while you're out on the town as they may trigger special events. The mini-map on the bottom left ought to come in handy too. Meet up with Fret. Who? Fert. I love how high, so much higher poly I am compared to everyone else. Also, what's going on with the FOV over here? Also, wait a minute. This is the place where that dude from Persona 5, the politician, would stand. Oh, the FOV is really weird. Happening with the dialogue. I want to look around the Shibuya crossing for a bit. I've actually been here, for those who don't know. In the real life. The Parco Mall, where the Nintendo store is kind of nearby here. If I'm not mistaken. I don't know how accurate this would be. But it would be... See over here, that red X, the no entry, the Parco Mall is down that way a little bit and to the right. I don't remember this being here. Also, there's like, I think it's this building here on like the fourth floor is just porn. or like not porn, but underwear model magazines, basically porn. I don't know how accurate this representation of Shibuya is.
Huh?
It's Swallow. Why are they named that? Wonder if they found something good on Fango.
Avery Dragon, hope you're not too tired from exams. Yeah, some days it feels like lovely spawns, but trash. I'll let you know if there's any monsters that pop up on my radar.
Oh, for real? Thanks. Well, I cannot take a game, seriously, where the main character goes, oh, for real? Exactly like that. I get it, they're texting, but like, fuck. Press the L button outside of the combat to sift through Window's thoughts. He jots down all the important info he learned, so review what he's recorded if you ever feel stuck. The camera angles are kind of fucking mental.
Oh! Huh?
That text is going way too fast for me to read it. Nope, it's not happening. Even if I was looking at and reading it, it's going kind of fast. Like, not even voice acting. I don't know if I'd be able to keep up with that in normal gameplay.
Hmm? Yep.
Doganzanga. Ganganropa. Gang beasts.
My Rin dude! You finally made it!
Wow. There he is.
Yeah, no thanks to you.
My bad. Anyway, I had to line up for a little something I've had my eye on.
Okay.
Well, don't you want to know what I bought?
Not really.
Aw, you're killing me. Give me a guess.
Fine. Clothes?
Nope.
Bummer.
Come on, work with me here.
Fine. What is it?
Hint, there's one for each of us.
Some kind of food?
Ta-da!
What is it?
A nice Reaper noise. Pin, duh. Haven't you seen them on everyone's book bags?
Maybe.
But how does this connect to the threes?
Of course, everyone's got them.
And then there's like
anyway,
a brown
was,
four
checking the selection,
in the same row. My brain is still in Picross mode right now. I want to play more Picross.
Not just any pins, Rin dude. These things have got value. Enough to make me, of all people, wait in line for them. Here, see for yourself.
Huh?
Oh. You fucking suck, dude.
Hey, watch it! If you lose it, I can't buy you another!
Dude, you practically threw it at me. Oh, thanks.
Doesn't
look that special to me.
It's a badge. You'll equip it for 4 BP, and then you can do power bounce.
I gotta say, I'm feeling kinda hungry.
Eh?
Come on, let's grab a bite.
We could, I guess.
All right, now we just gotta figure out what to eat. I was thinking either
this
ramen
is how
or
real
curry.
People talk,
let's
by the way.
Let's head to Doganzaka and go from there.
I would know. I'm not real. So yeah, I didn't actually get anywhere near the Shibuya 104 building. I don't even know what's actually in there. I saw it from a distance, but my time in Shibuya was not dedicated towards the tourism. The tourism was for other parts of Tokyo and Kyoto.
Hey!
Hey! Yeah, that's what he said. So, what's your stomach telling you?
I think he's fine with anything.
Well, let's narrow down our options.
If it feels like ramen, there's a place right over there.
Right.
And there's also a great Indian place right around the corner. Oh, and I want to check out that new curry place. Although it looks like it's not open yet. So, tell your tummy it's either ramen or Indian.
The music's cool. I'm definitely getting killed by DMCA gods for this.
Hey!
We're going here.
So, this is the Indian place. Man, I could eat curry for every meal. This look okay to you? I don't know what difference it makes, but sure, let's do it.
Yep.
That's my Rin, dude. Let's get it. Wait, stop calling me Rim Job. Table for two, please. All right, time to dig it. This is not good for the streamer who forgot to eat before he went live. Looks great. It's not great. It's just, it's amazing. Huh? Oh, it's swallow again. Stop calling me that. Nut! Yep, that's a squirrel. Look at the... Not the papu you wanted, but look what I just caught. Oh, nice.
Hey!
What's up? Give me a sec. Nutkin! Nutkin! Yo, wait, why is there a Moogle? Oh, right, it's Square Enix. Where'd you find it? Shibuya showed up right in the middle of the crossing. Shibuya? No way. You're in Shibuya? Me too.
Rin dude.
Who are you texting? Who is this mysterious person? Just a friend I met from Van Gogh said they found something good at the crossing. Nice! So, what's a Fango? A game. Oh, right, that monster collecting thing. Is it fun? Can I try? Could be around here somewhere. Oh, the monsters? Which one? Want to catch them? What? No, my friend. Oh. Wait, who's this friend and why haven't I met them? I mean, technically, I haven't either.
Whoa!
Dude, they're at the Scramble Crossing right now! They were, but they probably left. Haven't even read my messages yet. But they just texted you, right? They left. They couldn't have gotten far. We could still catch your friend and that monster. You know, two things with one you.
I mean...
No, it's... I get it.
Come on.
Too late. My mind's made up. Let's move, Rin, dude. Oh, I was standing outside in reality the whole time. Mama! That's a lot of pins. Holy shit. Different threads, food. Okay. Interesting. Interesting. So I wonder. Wait, hang on. Let me. Oh, never mind. Sorry. Pardon me, faceless chap. Your lack of eyes is very appealing today. See what I tell you about texting and walking. Eyes on the road, buddy. It's called peripheral vision. More like blind spot. Less talking, more walk. I wanted to do. Okay, thanks, Mysterious. Mysterious M&M man. How did I access that other menu before? No.
Let me think this through.
There we go. Just wanted to look around the, I'm trying to think. I want to say... Oh, based on this map here. Let's see. I'm trying to remember if I can figure out where, if this is even accurate, where the Parco Mall was at. I want to say it's like here in this zone. So we don't get to go to the Parco Mall in this. No Nintendo store visits. Or the Capcom store. Or the Pokemon store. Or the jewelry shop on the
second floor. The camera angles are kind of cool-ish. They're a little distracting, though. We made it to scrambled eggs. Hog Fang.
So who exactly are we looking for? Dude, just forget it.
Your mask is doing so much on your chin there, buddy.
What the?
Oh, fuck. Remember that?
What's going on?
Look out!
Rin, dude. You okay?
Gamers hate this frame rate despite it trying to be cinematic.
No! Did you see that?
No.
They're shooting off fireworks. Let's check it out, Rin, dude. Dude, wait up!
That's a weird firework. I don't think fireworks are supposed to look like dogs. Oh, you killed... Oh, no, the dog!
Whoa, it's like a movie about people who can do that thing. What's that called? You know, the brain power thing.
Why is he flying?
It's gonna drive me crazy. Come on, think. Oh, psychokinesis? Bingo! Fret, how come we're the only ones paying attention? Maybe they're all part of the crew?
Only you can see now.
I've got a bad feeling about this. Yeah, I'm starting to get one, too.
Greetings. Sheeple of Shibuya.
Got that is not how you pronounce it. Shibuya.
No, I got a horrible feeling.
Is it?
Run!
Or maybe I'm is it?
A new game has finally begun.
Shibuya. That doesn't feel right. Dead.
I've seen this before.
This isn't the first time I played a game where a blonde, shaggy-haired character can see the future, and then his best friend dies underneath a truck.
Fred, are you okay? Wait, what's happening?
Oh, maybe the choppy frame rate wasn't a style.
Greetings. Sheeple.
Oh, time travel.
Got some red hot news for you.
Now I got a horrible feeling. Fret, run! Not that way!
A new game has finally begun.
I don't know what's going on, or what any of this means.
Is that Scott the Waz?
Just make it
stop! Hey, yo! The voice sounded like Scott.
That was close!
Looks like the action is really heating up.
Yep. That's right. You just got invaded by a ginger. Orange hair must be a villain. Oh, I'm absolutely getting fucking DMCA nuked. The music's cool. I don't know if this is licensed or original, but it's cool. Naggy. Now! I mean, visually, this game looks great, honestly. Damn. whoever that was. My eyes are experiencing something. Okay, so this game's got goth cat girls. An interesting combination, to say the least. The fucking juxtaposition of the music right now. Just going from like nice, you know, music to this. Yeah, okay, no more. All right. Makes sense. It checks out. I wonder how much game is actually available with this.
Whew, so what game was that guy talking about? And why is it so dangerous?
Your guess is as good as mine.
Are you kidding? More new players?
Correct.
And here I thought I was done for the day.
Oh, here's the goth cat girl. You can tell based on the goth cat...
Window Conade.
Phone.
Tosai Furusawa.
Toasty?
Can we help you?
Miss...
Shoka Sakurane, one of the Reapers.
Oh, okay, yeah, sure. I know what that means.
Don't play dumb. I saw your psychs. Which means now I've got to get you bozos registered.
Huh? Register for what?
For the Reapers game? Did you not notice that your phones got updated, or...
Wow, look at that.
Anyway, you're all set. Welcome to the RNS.
Didn't this game come out in like 2006? How'd they have smartphones back then?
Reaper Networking Service. Be sure to check the official account.
Official account?
Yes. And these are your starter pins.
What for?
You earn points with them.
What is going on with the music?
You win the game.
But how do we earn points?
And having like vocals during a cutscene like this is kind of distracting.
So ask someone else, would you? Like another player or another Reaper. Literally anyone but me. And I'm out. Later, losers.
Even if it is at least mixed down, it's kind of weird and distracting.
Did she just say Reaper? Like Grim Reaper?
I mean, that's what I heard.
Yikes, she was giving off some scary vibes.
Almost as scary as those explosions. Think those were part of this game too? Huh?
No, it's part of Minecraft, usually. Not part of this game. Like, the explosions aren't... World Ends With You doesn't have explosions. Minecraft does. There's TNT in that game. I am Steve, said Jack Black. Oh, wow, it is Persona.
Where'd this come from? Ah, right. Must be that RNS.
Wherever it came from, it looks like it replaced my usual app. Huh, says something about a team. Like a group chat? Wanna make one?
Not much point when you're the only one left in my contacts.
It's kind of hard to play RPG demos on stream. Especially when they're this story-driven.
You kids must be the newbies. Oh, fresh out of the box, ain't ya?
The best kinds of demos to showcase on this segment are ones where you jump in and get straight to gameplay. You can save the story for when I get the real game.
What's so funny?
You just couldn't help yourself.
I think this is one of those demos where the save data will transfer, but still.
Teamed up with a pro instead of painting a big old target on your backs.
Target us?
This fucking Linkin Park.
You start in last place. You get stuck down there. And before you know it, you get erased.
This voice isn't very fitting for this massive man.
Well, who are you then?
He sounds like me.
The name's Kaichi Suzuki!
The name's Kaichi Suzuki!
See?
But my teammates call me Suzuki-chi!
Okay.
We Ruinbringers are the best team in the game.
Is that so?
By game,
I like the style of this a lot. Let me just
wait.
I know I'm like shitposting here, but I do.
You discs don't even know what game you're playing. I'd say it's only a matter of time till somebody sweeps
you. I did do this to myself by selecting the English dub.
Not yet, at least, seeing as you're starting so far behind. Too bad. But hey, maybe you got some untapped potential. Only one way to find out. You want to stave off erasure? Then see if you can handle the noise.
I don't hear anything.
Do you even know how to scan, bro? You don't hear the noise, you see it. And to do that, you gotta focus. Close your eyes, quit thinking, and just feel. Huh? What the hell? Whoa. What? And so it begins. Blacks played their disc, white to move. Every region is yours for the taking. It's flip or get flipped. Erase or face erasure. That's how you play the game. A minute to pick up, a lifetime to perfect.
Flip,
Squirtle, I'm dying.
He lost me.
Don't sweat it too much. You ain't gonna get it right the first time around. So just play the game and keep it loud. And if I see the discs trying to make any quiet moves, I'll break the board in two.
Does he mean us?
No.
Did you understand any of that?
No.
How the hell could I?
Oh, because I brought that. Oh, there
you go. I haven't understood a single thing that's happened since you picked up those creepy pins.
Hey, can't spell confusion without fun, right? Never heard of a game where you see sounds or whatever, but it might be cool. Let's do it.
Whatever you say.
You can't spell constipation without at least one letter from my name. Hi! Scanning will visualize enemies known as the noise. Pizza time? Touch their symbols, representing them to initiate combat. Oh, I just phased through people. Yeah, I'm gonna go over here. No?
Gotta focus. What to do?
Wait a minute.
Let's have a look.
L and scan the noise.
Let me think this through.
Yeah. Music.
Gotta focus.
Let's have a look.
Oh.
Gotta focus. What to do?
How do I scan? Oh. Wait, why does it say L, but you actually press R? Rindo and the gang can tap their latent psychic powers using the pins they've equipped. Use the button assigned to the given pin to unleash its corresponding psych. Tilt the left stick to move the character you last used. Target foes by tilting the right stick and evade their attacks by pressing the B button.
Sorry, but you're no match for me.
Okay. It's loading.
Think we bit off more than we can chew here.
Frog! Oh, it's a hack and slash.
You sure did.
I was waiting for the gameplay to begin. It has finally begun. Not what I was expecting out of this gameplay.
You sure did.
But... Yeah! I'm into it. Maybe.
Nice one, Rintu.
It's over. Oh,
we got this.
We win.
It took a while to get started, but.
Oh,
Nice texture. Stock image of concrete with blood. I am getting fucking DMCA. Like, not only are they going to kill me, but they're going to kill, like, seven, like, generations from me. Like, my bloodline is ruined. My roast is ruined!
What?
Huh? So how'd we manage to do that?
Hell if I know.
We press the A button and the Y button. Against the world! Okay, be honest, buddy. How cool did I look just now? It was like AR or something. Except instead of augmented reality, it was awesome reality.
Hey!
Seriously? That's what you're worried about? Well, what else am I supposed to be worried about? Don't overthink it, my Rin dude. Just embrace the super cool powers.
Wait, let me check something. Let's see. Welcome to the Reaper's game. Access the RNS. Find the official account. Today's mission here. Utilize your psych to erase the target. Receive your orders before the faithful dog. The path to the target shall open to those who follow. Yes, sir, Mr. Epps, sir. So, faithful dog, think they're talking about Hachiko?
I don't know.
Well, there's only one way to find out. Which would be by heading to old Hachinko and seeing for ourselves, of course!
Yeah, not like we've got anything better to do.
Press the plus button during combat to pause the action. You're not feeling a fight, select runaway and your team will split. Keep in mind that you won't be able to run from every encounter.
Damn.
Well, you can't change the difficulty in the demo. So you'll eventually be able to increase or decrease your levels, like Xenoblade, like expert mode.
That's cool.
Wish I could, wish I could tilt the camera wherever I want. Just kind of look around.
Whoa, what the hell?
What is it now?
I was taking my galaxy brain for a test run and...
Dude, quit messing around. You'll summon more of those monsters.
We can take them. We'll be fine.
If you say so.
Anyway, so as I was saying before you so rudely interrupted me, I did the scanning thing and suddenly I could hear these voices.
The people around us.
See, that's what I thought, but check it out, their lips aren't moving.
Oh, it's because the budget wasn't high enough for that.
And now I can't tell where the voices are coming from.
That is kind of weird. Like you're reading people's minds or something.
Whoa! That's it! Mind reading! Maybe! Give it a whirl, Rin, dude. See for yourself.
Might as well, I guess.
Press the R button to scan your surroundings.
Let's have a look.
This is my first time really. Can you help me? I'm gonna do some stuff and I'm just gonna over it. You're gonna be my favorite.
I don't think this is how people think. Then again, I don't think. So.
Dang, we really can read people's minds. This is so cool. Man, I'm getting all psyched up.
Very funny. So this is part of the game too. How does that even work?
Don't know. Don't care. Come on, let's go get to Hype Chachiko.
Wouldn't want to be late.
Late for what? Fred?
Jeez, what's with this? What's the deal with this game?
You're telling me.
Personified. Live cam?
Huh?
There's a live cam set up around here somewhere. I'm gonna find it and look straight into it. This could be my big break. From at Hey Look At Me. Is this the Hachiko we were looking for? Pretty sure it's the only Hachiko. Just me, or is that guy there seem kind of creepy? Yeah, no, yeah, he's totally sus.
Sup?
Hey, you two, you blaze? Yeah. Oh, shit, he's talking to us! What do you do? Calm down there, pal. You kids strike me as a couple of newbies. We do? I guess we technically are. Okay, I knew it. Just try not to get yourselves erased right out the gates. Yes, sir. Got it, sir. Disappearing doesn't sound so bad right now, actually. Looks directly into camera. Don't be like that. You gotta play to win. Now ready for your mission? Have a look. Mission? Where's that game thing? Does that mean the game is starting? Let's see. Reveal the skull's true colors. Yep, that's what it says. Skulls? What skulls? Where are they? How do we find them? Try using your own two skulls and figure it out. Yeah, but what are all these stripes about? What do A, B, C, and D mean? I feel like I've seen this somewhere before. Should be a piece of cake. Just think Shibuya. The stripes are a crosswalk! Wow. It's the Scramble Crossing. It is Persona 5 Scramble. See? Wasn't that hard, was it? Okay, but I'm still stuck on all the letters. Maybe they're supposed to mark places around the crossing. You better check them out. Once you figure out those skulls' colors, head back here. Have fun. Head to the spots labeled A through D. Okay. I'm starting to lose my patience. There's a lot of story happening, which is cool. But again, a demo showcase is not the best place to start looking into story. I'm just in Shibuya. No big deal. Whoa, Scramble Crossing is so cool. Is that 104? And there's Shibuya. It's just like in the movies. Moody. Hachiko Cafe is great, but the barista changes the menu all the time. Hope she put in an extra chips in the chocolate scone kind of mood today.
Gotta focus.
Finally made it out of the impregnable labyrinth-like dungeon known as Shibuya Station. I think this is a D. Don't see any skulls, though. Yep, no skulls. What's this weird mark? Oh, hi, Mark. Ha-ha. It's like one of those noise symbols worth investigating. Think we have to fight something?
Let's have a look.
Rebooting your pins. Using a cycle can consume energy from the gauge displayed below its pin. When the gauge is depleted, you'll have to wait until the pin reboots.
All right! Who wants a piece of fret?
All right, my second fight. Finally. 30 minutes into this demo.
Don't get careless.
Drop the beat.
Ain't no stopping us now. We got this.
Oh, I'm tired.
Done for. Hey, not bad. Just keep your eyes on me.
What is this?
Are we awesome?
awesome or what?
I think I missed a QTE.
I feel like we deserve better.
I am so confused by the music. Like, I enjoy it. It is very well-made music. And let me also clarify, I like video game music that can have lyrics. But when, like, the majority of the soundtrack is oops, all lyrics, that's when you kind of start to lose me. Couple of, like, character themes with music, with lyrics is cool, but I don't know. I'm reading this to myself at this point.
Hey.
So that way I can get through it a little faster. The manhole cover. The school is in love. Looks like our skull, and it's a red one. So D is red. D.
Gotta focus.
Where's A?
Let's have a look. Gotta focus.
How about that? Was just getting the one good enough for you? I thought we were supposed to get all four of them.
Really? Let's have a look.
We are. That pattern. One of the rarest manhole covers in Japan.
Gotta focus. Let's have a look.
Right, if I focus, I can stop time for some reason. This traffic fucking blows!
Let's have a look.
I think I'm done with this demo. We'll save for an unknown reason. Even though I won't be coming back to this. I mean, it seems like it's a fine enough game. I don't know. It's just, again, like, story games that really, really, like, try to push its story and focus less on actually demoing the game are not good demos, in my opinion. Like, that is a way to do a demo, yes. Give you, like, a slice of the game itself, like, in its literal form, and be like, this is what you're getting yourself into. Are you invested in the story? You know, are you invested in the gameplay? Especially when a game is all about story, you know, It makes sense why that is what they push, but I don't know. For me, the best kind of demos are the ones where you just get in there, you play a couple of levels, you see what the game itself is like, and then you kind of go from there, you know? So with that, let's do something that is going to be a little more gameplay focused then. And I think we're going to find that in this one. We'll try this. I don't know what it is. There's an update for it. Never mind. All right. That's going to take some time, I'm sure. Also, I'm not sure if I'm actually going to end up doing Fight Night tonight. Just because there seems to be no viewers right now. And I want people to actually kind of watch me play the fight game, and maybe that's what they're waiting for, but I don't know. I think I'm gonna go ahead and let's try the Epic Mickey demo. Sure. This one will probably not be, like, super story focused, right? This is a remake of Epic Mickey, which I've never played. I think we had
as a kid, Epic Mickey 2 on Wii U, but I never played it. My younger brother did, but I did not. I've heard people say that this series is very good, and that it was super insane to see Epic Mickey come back in any form. It's a long load screen. Holy shit. Hello? Huh? Is this demo broken? A minute of pure black screen and silence. Not even anything. Huh? Whoa. Whoa, that was bad. A whole minute of just like fucking nothing. Holy shit. Not off to a good start. I'll let it slide. It is the Switch, but fuck. Switch doesn't generally have that shit of load times. A long time ago. Oh, this is very quiet.
My mirror lured someone out of his bed.
Even with full boost, it's still quiet. Huh?
To my workshop. I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous or malicious. Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project.
Do you think Disney will kill me just for, like, showing Mickey Mouse on screen?
I was putting the finishing touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten.
Yeah. Like Xenoblade X on Switch. That was forgotten. A Rappa the Rappa was also forgotten.
I put the magic brush down and retired to my chambers.
Until the Astrobot made a Parappa reference, I'm sure.
Had I known what events would follow,
why is Mickey being mischievous?
Paint, brush, and thinner.
Something really interesting that I've always found regarding the design of Mickey Mouse is it's really weird when you pay really close attention to his ears. How they always face you. Like, the shape of the Mickey Mouse head is always prevalent. There is not an angle that you can possibly look at Mickey at where you see the head at, like, a different angle. The ears will go on the back of his neck. Oh, now look what you've gone and done.
Voices and rushed to see what had happened. But I was too late. The world I had created was ravaged. A wasteland. The mysterious intruder was gone. I did not learn his identity. Well, not for a very long time.
Steamboat Willie, that part was royalty free. They don't own the rights to that. No one does. Oh God, November 18th. Oh, it's goopy. It's like the goopy inferno. There he goes. The voice acting's pretty good on this. Charming. Mickey noises. Michael Mouse. All right, now time for 4 minutes of loading screen. Oh, nope, just kidding. We're good. I'm always scared to do anything Disney related on stream. I just feel like I'll be like just erased, eradicated. Which is like, how the hell does Square and Disney not like eradicate each other? That's like a black hole fighting against the sun, right? Like what's more powerful? There's probably actually a scientific answer to that, but like, there's indomitable will versus unstoppable force. How does Kingdom Hearts exist with two of the most like IP hog known like publishers? I don't know if that's the right word for it necessarily, but just like, yeah, whatever the fuck Square is and Disney, how do they both exist? Ah, oh, they crucified him. And then there's whoever that is. Rabbit. Ooh. Why are they doing this to Mickey? Corkscrew. Oh, don't corkscrew him. Is he trying to find something Mickey's going to enjoy, or what's he waiting for? Oh, shit. We're going to take your heart out. Holy shit. How did he do that? You sure got him. Oh, I hate paint. This rabbit boy is, but goodbye. Oh. The game went from looking fucking phenomenal to this. I wonder if this has other versions or if it's Switch exclusive. I think the original was like Wii only, right? And then Wii U. So, like, somehow this is, like, Nintendo. Why is there no sound effects while this thing moves? Okay. What are you? We're in a safe spot, Mickey. This control panel can be damaged with your spin move. Press Y. Wow, the frame rate. The control panel's broken. Come take care of this one. Wow, there's just no sound effects to anything in this. It started off really impressive, and then gameplay. Okay. Not a single sound effect for all of that animation. That's so weird. Especially for like a Disney property, you would know that they should know to pair sound effects with your actions. Maybe this is like an early version of the game, I don't know. But it's a remaster, so I'm assuming it had to have been this way in the original, right? Why wouldn't they have changed that? What? I did it. I made it over here. Who are you? Dead. Okay, it happens sometimes. To the best of us. Oswald. Benevolent ruler of Wasteland. Yeah, then who's this? Goswald. Ghostly form of Oswald's brother uncle. They're both brothers and uncles. The family, don't ask about the family. It's fucked up. Oh shit, world ends with you, Pin. Okay. I have a feeling that this game will be loved by people who grew up with the original or played the original. But it's not doing a lot to sell me on it right now. It started off really strong and then kind of dropped the ball. I'm gonna give it some time, though, before I write it off. I'm being a little harsh on today's demo showcase. For that, I'd like to apologize. These games deserve better. I think I'm just moody.
Mickey's Bash and Day.
I don't remember where the guy gets went. Where he go?
Where did that guy gas to?
Huh? Sorry, I don't mean to yawn. It's very rude of me. Good. So there seems to be things that are like not properly in this dimension. Things that exist elsewhere in the world. Good morning, Vel. How you doing? Huh. Okay. I'm assuming this is the way to go, then. Aww. Oh. Hmm. This looks nice. Thing is made of paint thinner. That blot seemed awfully scared of this brush. Oh!
Well, it's thinner! It dissolves out into paint!
I'm not doing a Mickey voice. I can't do a Mickey voice.
That's paint! Dissolves out of made blue thinner.
Oh, but then he loses a little part of himself.
You just force back.
Soaked up some of the blot. Use ZL. Oh. And here's the original Wii controls, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, okay, so you can use... Just noticed was muted. You had the stream muted. Oh.
No, actually, no. See, you arrived, and then I said nothing. I just was like, this is my stream.
This is all the stream is capable of being. It's nothing. Sir. Oh. I guess it's too late at this point, but if I had access to that area still, I could remove or add to the wall. That's a cool idea behind a game, I guess. You can remove and add things to the corporeal form. But how much deeper will it get? Will it just be you see a thing that's in one dimension? Either get it out of your way or put it in your way. In the gear. The gyro controls aren't that bad. I'm not having to, like, waggle or anything. It's just a slight movement. And I can still move with the analog sticks if I, you know, don't want to worry about the waggle or the gyro. It's not waggle. Brush can also thin out cartoon objects like that door frame. And remove. You can remove pretty much. I guess you can't really remove anything, but... you can remove most things. And then if you completely... Okay. Completely remove it, and then the door has nothing to hold itself. Okay. I like the idea. The game is winning me back again. Dropped the ball hard on the visuals by giving me such a beautiful opening cinematic, and then, you know, this the graphic. I would get this if this was on other platforms. Oh, yeah, there's some visual bugs, for sure. Which is weird, because, it's a remake of a Wii game. So... would have thought that they would have ironed out some of these kinks by now. But nay. Oh. Okay. Just shat out that eyeball. The blotting army. What are they blotting? How'd you animate that chalkboard? them with thinner and then hit them with paint to turn them friendly. Okay. Did you know in video games you can die? Switch is just not the most powerful console. This is true. And I can't exactly fault... I can't expect every company to, like, take the time and budget to learn how to optimize on Switch. Especially when, you know, it's as unpowerful as it is, right? Like, this thing is about the power of, like, two generations ago. Especially if game devs are focusing on, you know, developing for modern hardware. To try to develop for the Switch is to ask a game to be ran on fucking 10-year-old hardware, if not older than that. I mean, the console itself is 7 years old, but even when it came out, it was already a generation behind. So... like, yeah, I can't exactly expect it to just, you know, be the god gaming console that I want it to be. However, what I'm trying to get at is it is possible to make Switch games look really good. I don't expect Switch 2 to be anything remarkable as far as power is concerned. I hope it's an upgrade at the very least. Otherwise, I'm really going to be questioning why I'm buying this thing. Oh, I can just remove doors in general. Like, okay, let's realistically look at what we're working with here, you know, on a fundamental level here. This is a pretty detailed environment. Large, well animated, like everything here is well animated. For what this game is worth, this doesn't really look that bad. It's just, damn, did that cinematic look like fucking gorgeous. Like, oh, you gorgeous, baby. Like, that kind of gorgeous. Extra content unlocked. Alright. If the entire game looked like that, it would be, like, fucking stunning. Which, I bet if this game does have other versions, then it would. As long as a game is in 60 FPS, I'd be fine. Well, see, that's the other thing, too. Like, okay, yeah, when it comes to, like, crusty, like, I don't need, like, anti-aliasing in, like, all these nice lighting effects. What I will care more about is a steady frame rate. I don't need it to be 60. This discussion has been happening a lot on the internet lately. A lot of people have been discussing, like, I need my games to be 60 FPS. I don't. I mean, 60 FPS is nice when it's included, don't get me wrong, but 30 is a very serviceable frame rate. But the problem is, even if a game is running at 30 FPS, if it's starting to have frame dips, then we're really starting to have problems. Forgive me for not reading this dialogue. If I were to pick this game up outside of the demo and actually try it, I would be reading the dialogue, but I wish to experience the demo. I want to actually complete a demo tonight and not just end one end them all prematurely. Oh, you can run fast. Okay, good. I don't know what is new and what isn't new in this version, by the way. Running could be new for all I know. If there's an option to play games at 60 while some versions don't, I'd gravitate towards the 60 version. You know what is really weird? There are no games outside of one that I can think of on Switch, which I'm sure there's more, but like, I can only think of one game where you have the option between graphics or frame rate, like performance mode versus quality mode or whatever. And of all games, it's fucking Fire Emblem Warriors, the first one. The bad one. Like, what? How'd they get away with that game only? I was really expecting even, like, future Warriors games to, like, implement that, but nope. It was just Fire Emblem Warriors, the first one, not even in the Fire Emblem Warriors sequel game. I don't get it. Yeah, like PC games will do that a lot, but I'm talking like specifically Switch. Wait, is Mickey sentient that he's a cartoon? So this is like, I guess like Mario 64 now. Now you go in the painting and you end up in the other world. And now it's a 2D platforming game. What? Huh? This game's volume is all over the place, by the way. I am boosting this by 8 decibels right now. And this is as loud as it is. That's a lot of boost. Typically, like, 3 decibels would be, like, reasonable. Like, okay. It's a little quieter of a game, sure. Boost it by 3, get it to my preferred volume. But no. This is a game that if you want to hear the entire soundtrack, you are putting your TV volume at 100. And even then, you'll be like, what? Who? So that's the end of it. Received Mickey in the Bean. Salam. Yes. I'm sure if I was a bigger Mickey Mouse fan, that this game would be like truly something kind of magical. You know, I see what it's doing. It's got like classic, you know, Disney Mickey Mouse, you know, cartoon references. I've mentioned this before. I am not really that big of a Disney guy. It's probably the biggest reason why I've never really given the Kingdom Hearts series any real chance, is because, like, aside from Aladdin and, like, maybe a small number of other Disney properties, I'm not really that big of a Disney fan. Like, I like some of the things that Disney now owns, but I don't call Star Wars a Disney franchise, despite what Disney wants me to believe. And I'm not even that big of a Star Wars fan, but just, like, as an example. Technically, Family Guy is a Disney franchise, right? Because they own Fox. Wait, but this Family Guy, are they still owned by Fox or did they sell out? I don't know. I figured out what we can do here. I guess Marvel is also owned by Disney now, right? Deadpool made plenty of jokes about that. I'm not really a big Marvel guy either, though. Like, I like Spider-Man. I like Deadpool, I guess. I liked the first couple of Iron Man movies. In general, Marvel movies have pissed me off in recent years in that they are just slop. My thing with movies in general, and this is less to do with, I guess, the state of movies, but just as a general thing. I feel like a lot of modern movies really struggle to tell an interesting story in the short amount of time that a movie allots. Like, a television show is always going to be, or even streaming for that matter, but just a show. Oh, God. A show is going to be far more interesting to me than a movie. Because with a show, if you give it, you know, the right amount of time, you can really take the time to develop characters and make an interesting plot. Whereas even the best of movies, the plot has to be like really fast paced. And either not a lot happens in the plot, or so much happens so quickly that it kind of becomes overwhelming. But with Marvel movies in general, for me lately, it's just been like, yeah, Deadpool was fine. It was funny. But, like, the plot of the movie was a nothing burger. I don't think anyone was going there for the plot. Especially not myself. But what's your step here? Using double jump to reach the platform. Okay, yeah, I know that. Thank you. Oh! Chest down there. It's kind of fun to run around this game. I'm not gonna lie. After I got invested in, like, in the gameplay loop, I could see this being fun. Mickey controls well. He's not, like, awkward to control by any means. He stops when I stop. Doesn't have, like, weird momentum. His jump is a little floaty, but not to, like, an annoying degree. He can make some good headway with his double jump. Needs to be a movie because it's a movie, and the story and other aspects are taken for granted because it's a movie? Again, no sound effects with the animations. It's really weird. We are friends now. Maybe. Splatters are rarely solitary creatures. Beat the shit out of that guy for me. Goodbye. All right. It's really weird. It's not like this game doesn't have sound effects. It's just like large objects that should have like really heavy, meaty sounds are just completely absent of any sound design. Like that door slamming shut, no sound. The other gate, like, rising up, like, where's, like, the clanks? They must have heard me clanking, like, where's all that? But the guy fucking with the gear, that had sound effects attached to it, so really weird. Again, not really a problem, more just like, huh? Is that a stylistic choice, or is it a budget thing, I wonder? Or is the game just unfinished and this is like an early access demo? I have no idea. I think this comes out soon. This demo, I believe this game is not yet out with a full version. But also, like, I'm sure we're going to talk about this more once we start on the Pixel Pulse episode. Wait, hold art. Maybe I should pay attention. Hang on. Thanks. Dumbo. Are we sure this isn't Kingdom Hearts? Oh god, the frame rate here is a little weird. Just a little weird frame rate. Never hurt no one except for me, of course. And my eyes. What was I about to say, though, before? Nope, I lost my train of thought. You can be my friend now. We are made of friend. Oh, I was gonna say, yeah, like with like the Minecraft movie, for example, recently. It's like, what's the inspiration behind the Minecraft movie? I know what the real answer is. The real answer is money. But like, that movie just, it feels like, why would I want to watch this? This is clearly made just so people can get, like, a paycheck. It feels very passionless. Like, okay. They stated that the movie started production 10 years ago. Right? But part of the reason why it took so long to come out was that they were struggling to figure out a good story for the movie. Well, no fucking shit. We're talking about Minecraft. The game with like the least amount of story out of any game ever. Baby. I'm sure that's not true. There is Picross after all. I didn't even use any of my guardians. Okay. Thanks. But yeah, like, it's very clear that the reason why it took them forever to make the movie is because it's just uninspired slop. No one made that movie because they're like, you know, I have a really good idea. I think we should make a Minecraft movie because I think there's something that we can achieve through making a Minecraft movie that we couldn't otherwise achieve. Like, I think that is what movies should be for. There's a specific kind of storytelling that you can do with movies that, if you made it into a show, it'd just be too long-winded. And if you made it into a game,
Well, there's tie-in games, so I guess it's not necessarily fair. But, like, I don't know, a movie can be nice because you just sit down, you watch it, and you experience it, and then after a couple hours, it's done, you know? You, the viewer, don't have to put in any effort. It's not like you have to, like, solve puzzles and shit. You know, you're just there. You're experiencing it. I don't know. At the end of the day, you know, who gives a shit if the Minecraft movie's gonna be ass? Sure, I like Minecraft on the surface level. But I don't care. I wasn't expecting the movie to be good. But, like, this is gonna be a really unpopular opinion, I know. I might get some shit for this. But the Sonic movie also feels uninspired this way as well for me. The Sonic movie feels like a studio executive, either Sega or maybe the movie, wherever. I don't really know the story, but it feels like someone said, I want to make a movie. And then they said, how can we sell this? Let's attach the brand Sonic the Hedgehog to it. I will say that the Sonic movie is far more cohesive and does a decent job and I am a Sonic fan, and let me state, I love Jim Carrey's acting, especially in the second movie. The second movie was better than the first by a long shot for me, and I still enjoyed the movie. But, I'm gonna tell you right now, the last thing I want to see when I go watch a Sonic movie is him doing a Fortnite dance. I mean, to some extent, I guess it is kind of in character for him, because he's like this like edgy teenager. I don't know if edgy is the right word, but he's like a delinquent, right? I'm also just getting really sick of nerding out over celebrities. Like, what's a celebrity famous for? Being famous? A lot of them are. Like, I see a lot of people loving Keanu Reeves as Shadow the Hedgehog. And I'll admit, you know, out of all the celebrity castings that they could have done for, like, major A-listers, yeah, they made a good choice there. But you know what would have worked even better than Keanu Reeves, in my opinion? The actual Shadow the Hedgehog voice actor. And what remains to be a fucking mystery is how Colleen O'Shaughnessy remains the voice of Tails. I'm not complaining by any means. I think that's fucking awesome. But why is it just Tails that gets their regular voice actor? You know? Not that I'm, like, trying to bitch or anything, but just, like, it's... Oh, okay, that's the end of that, I guess. The abrupt end to the demo. It's less that, like I'm happy for Colleen. I just am, like, wondering, like, why does Sonic have to be, you know, Ben, whatever his name is, Star? No, whatever. You know, why do we have to have these mainstay celebrity actors to do these roles? It's like Jack Black as Steve is like, well, what's the point of that? Again, we had this discussion on Pixel Pulse. The answer is, for some reason, people see the celebrity name and then they go watch the thing
purely on the basis of the celebrity being involved. But I'm sitting here like, what the fuck? I don't care if Jack Black is Steve. What is Steve's role? You know? Same with, like, Chris Pratt. You know, the executives have stopped giving a shit about, like, hiring people who are actually good for the role. And it's now just become this whole mess of which actors can we cherry pick? You know, which ones are going to give us the most in free sales? Like, I'm going to be honest. Jack Black is fine. I like his humor and all. But, like, Jablinski Games is not the reason why I have watched any movie that he's in. Maybe I'm in the minority here. But I can't say I've ever watched a single movie because of an A-list celebrity's involvement. Like, I just couldn't give less of a shit. Like, seriously. Ugh. Anyways, I'm fucking rambling the shit right now. That was the Epic Mickey demo. Just because I was talking about other shit doesn't mean I wasn't enjoying it. The gameplay was actually kind of fun. Sure, the story was a little not super engaging. But again, if I were to actually play that game, I would become a little more focused on the story. I think I'm going to pass on doing Fight Night tonight just because I'm hungry and I'm getting tired. But I will do one more demo, and I think it's going to be Gunbrella. This one's been calling to me. I don't know much about Gunbrella, but it looked cool. I'll reserve my judgment for any movie until they actually come out, of course. But just to wrap up the discussion, I think the writing of the movie is more important to me than what celebrities Umbrella. Are involved.
Umbrella.
Oh, I could probably turn the game volume back down.
Go ahead and put that back where it was.
Hey, everything's on max settings. This is some interesting Foley. These are very wet sound effects.
Gunbrella.
Shadow. I got my fucking zipper stuck in a hair dryer.
How did you even do that?
Don't ask.
I like how hard is the default. I'm gonna put it on normal mode. I don't know what this game is. It's basically a game where you use that one weapon from Splatoon. That's all I know. The one called
Gunbrella.
All right, this is Devolver Digital. Do you think Devolver Digital is gonna be okay since they can't do their E3 skits anymore? Like, what are they gonna do with all that budget? Make games? This game's loud as shit. Blood. Oh no, they put the blood. Doinksoft? Oh, that's a great name. There's the gun. Is this a horror game? I genuinely know, like, practically nothing about this game. I didn't even know it was a 2D slight, like, side-scrolling game, truthfully. Oh, no. Hey, you. Wake up.
Sorry, you're finally awake. Rise and shine, lad. Ah, that's better. You're making those noises again. Better your lights lit out. Rocked to sleep by Mother Sea. We'll be touching land any time now, then, lad. Ready yourself for go on board. And in case I forgot to say something, I hope you find what you're looking for.
Gunbrella.
There it is again.
Gunbrella! Over here, sleepyhead! And watch your step getting off that boat.
Infinite gun.
Ahoy, stranger. We've arrived safe and sound, just like I promised. Oh, I almost forgot. You dropped this while you were on board. You'll definitely be needing that. If you're looking for answers, try a big city, Allendale. Keep your eyes peeled, old lad. During my travels, I heard some sinister murmurs about this drabbed region. Makes me a bit uneasy, if I'm being honest. I told you before that contraption is unlike anything I've ever seen. I'm not one for weaponry, but it does have a certain elegance about it. And an insignia sure is interesting. Try asking around, pal. Lots of folks come and go, but each one of them passes through Allendale. If you take the train from Orwell, you'll be here in no time. Oh, well, you could catch a ride on a train. There's a quaint little shanty town just beyond the tracks. Smells like shit. But a train station is the quickest way to get to Allendale. I'd rather not get into it now, lad. I've got discoveries to make, and you have got some investigating to do, by the sound of it. Anyway, I can hardly tell the ghost stories apart from the night horrors these days. What's happening to my accent? Appreciate your concern, my lad, but my sleeping habits ain't none of your damn business, to be frank. It's been nice sitting with you, but I've got some work to finish up. Anyway, take care.
Got some, like, recoil to it. Objectives and intel are recorded in your journal. Open the journal with minus and navigate the pages with L. No fucking way to make me jump. Oh, wall jumps. Here we go. R to open Gunbrella. Open while aiming with L to perform dashes. Whoa. That's cool. Oh, it goes whenever you do that. Never mind. It's just coincidence. Hold R to utilize precision aiming. Okay. I can Super Metroid this. Tap B while holding L to swim. Perform an umbrella dash with R to move more quickly. Uh, I like the sound here. This game sounds cool. When your vitality is low, use a consumable. Use left and right to cycle through consumables. Hold L to consume that selected item. Okay. Yeah, actually, the sound design in this game is really good. The truth about consumables by Punctual Pete. Bandages will heal your vitality fully. Food items grant bonus vitality. Consume food items to add up to 3 points of additional protection. Armed with this truth, you can live a happy and healthy life. Vitality is returned. Okay. Benches for saving. Like Final Fantasy. Open on Gunbrella with R to block. Block immediately before contact to reflect bullets. Is there a parry? Nice. Oh, fuck. Fire! Some words are scribbled on the wall. Hey there. You're reading this. That means you got stuck here, just like me. Try pressing B while holding L down. Oh, God. Oh, that lizard fucking splorted. I don't feel good about that. I like lizards. Lizards are generally good creatures. Open the Gunbrella on a zip line to attach to it. Close it to disengage. Oh, this game is kind of cool. For that one friend of mine who's like, I can't play indie games because too many of them have 8-bit art styles. I'm sorry to say that you're missing out on what seems to be a pretty cool game. Railway system offers service to Orwell, Allendale, and Base Camp. All passengers must carry with them a valid train pass. Hello there.
ID, please.
You're not from around here. I don't need to see a train pass in order to let you ride. They're issued by Avalon Industries, so you'll have to speak to an officer if you want. Between you and me, I'm not looking too closely. You have one you can borrow. Nice saxophone. Was this fucking insane in the rain? I am in the rain. Yeah, bandage. Well, I'm also insane, I guess, as well.
Baka baka.
Why hasn't she written yet? Ah! Oh, excuse me, I'm just a bit lost in thought. I'm cleaning stuff up before Goldenrod comes to visit. I'm a little worried, though. Normally, she writes ahead of time. Did you need something? My apples are famous. Have a look. Are you a clown? Goodbye. Oh, man. I went this whole stream without coughing. I thought I was over it. Nope.
Peekaboo! Huh? You look lost and kind of sketchy.
So I have infinite rounds right now, but I'm wondering if there's like upgrades where I have limited ammo.
Fishing, fishing, lovely fishing, opening my backpack with pasta. Look at my catch.
Okay.
Oh. Then say you're sad in it. I was all distracted thinking about fish. The contraption you got there. Where'd you get it out? I'm just a simple fisherman. I don't meddle with weapons. I haven't for a very long time. Oh, I'm glad you asked. A fellow lover of fishing is always welcome in my house. You know what? My life used to be a lot harder before I died and took up fishing. I'm not saying it's easy now. Hope a doll will be a kitchen heel. But it's the simple things that keep us afloat. You seem like you're carrying around a lot of weight, huh? You ever think of letting it go? Maybe it's time to return to the pond and go alive. Listen, I do not talk about these kinds of things, but maybe take the train to Allen Bay. You'll find someone who knows all about that weapon. I get to Allendale without a train pass, so I'd ask around town for it. Someone's probably got nectar. I'd tell you more, but I can't. Sick man probably has one. And even if he doesn't, I'll just take his. But he doesn't have one. No, I'll just take his. Baka baka. I'll take it, Baka. Oh, fuck. Underground bench. Okay, I'm in the sewers now for some unknown reason. I don't like shooting these frogs. I've never felt good about frog murder in my life. I prefer living a frog murder-free existence. You know? Oh, that's a bomb. Guess I probably could have figured that out a little sooner. Is there really nothing left? I love swimming. Maybe if I swim down. No? Okay, no. Do not submerge yourself in shit. I'm not coughing. Sorry, fella. The old breathers ain't what they ought to be. You know, how it is working the crude mind all day, every day. Cough, cough, cough. Cough, cough.
This is it for you, old man.
Who do you think you are? No one do someone sings like that. Not cool. Train bear. But
I... Can't tell me more. Well, let me take your train pass. Goldenrod. He lives in the next town east of here, Orwell. I have a photo, one sec. Thank you.
You know. Anyway, he's supposed to be coming to visit tomorrow, but I haven't heard anything yet. I'm a bit worried. Train line between here and Orwell gets shut down all the time. It doesn't mean anything or anything. Oh, you're heading to Allendale? That means you'll be passing through Orwell if you end up stopping. Well, can you keep an eye out for Golden Ryan? She's hard to miss. She has beautiful blonde hair and a sweet smile.
Ashtina, Tinta.
Yeah, thank you. You see, you tell her I'm worried, okay?
Oh.
Hmm? For keeping the rain off you, right?
Did you just come from the fisherman's house? I'm only asking because I need some rats, you see. Pretty good rats to be there. Why? Isn't it obvious? I like them. There's lots of them in the sewers. Lots of good rats. Behind the fisherman's house. Rat sewers. No, there's no wrong. I need three rats. No more, no less.
How do I bring them to you? Killing them? Collect rattle. Oh, the blood is still here. I guess that makes sense. It wouldn't just go away, would it?
One, two.
Rat full! Three rats acquired. Of course I'm a known rat collector. What else would I be? In this world, there are many paths that you can take. But if you exist as a rat collector, then you are number one.
Oh yes, a beautiful rat. Thank you. I'll take that. Oh yes, a beautiful rat. Thank you. I'll take that. Beautiful rat, thank you. I'm full up on beautiful rats. Heard you were looking for a train pack. Yes, take it. All I need is rats from now on. Nice doing business with you.
Is he about to spread rat plague? This poor, innocent village. Outer King Station. Holy shit. Oh, that train fast as fuck. I like the sounds. What appears to be the officer problem. Who are you? Uh-huh. I am dying. I'm still on fire. Oh, you actually have a gun. Well, this game is actually pretty hard. Did I put this on normal mode? Goodbye. Lads, I am getting, like, extreme hunger pangs at the moment. I should have eaten before I went live. I didn't think I was going to be this hungry because I had a big dinner. But I may have to end this a little early. But this one, other than Picross, this one is maybe the favorite demo of the stream tonight. What do I do about this? Not that. Yes, keep jumping into it. That'll solve the problem. Now, where's the electricity coming from? This generator over here. Oh, I was trying to heal. All right. Now I have tasted the bitter taste of defeat. Shit. I mean, that works, I guess. Okay, bye, asshole. So this is, yeah, I need to find a way to disable the electricity. I think if I just shoot the generator through the electricity, that'll probably work. Rifle rounds. Please exercise caution with this crude power generator. Do not poke, prod, or otherwise puncture this device in any way. Also, do not use up and down to cycle through all available ammo types, selecting a grenade. Do not use R to aim the grenade and then fire using Y. If you don't have a grenade, by no means should you pull the lever to the right of this side. Music is like fucking terrifying. Hey, give me more grenade. I'm sure that won't like blow up in my pocket or anything. As long as I don't pull the pin on accident. Don't get it caught on like a coat hanger or whatever. In that water. It's just my reflection? Oh, yeah. I thought there was like a lizard in there. All right. I know this isn't the full demo, but like I said before, I'm so fucking hungry that I kind of have to end here. But despite being kind of an all right selection of demos, this one was pretty good. Picross was pretty good. I think there's a Picross game on NSO. I might have to like fuck with that. So honestly, Picross seems like a cool concept to me, and it was very addicting to play. This was also very fun. And the Mickey game was good, too. I don't think I'm necessarily gonna play Mickey, but it was cool to experience. Now I can say that I sort of get it a little bit anyways. And Emio, I don't think I really spent enough time with Emio to really tell you if I like that game or not. I was unsure if it would be a good game for demo showcase, and it kind of wasn't, but, you know, again, anytime you do like big story games on demo showcase, if the demo is focused around story, it's going to be hard to figure out if it's a good game. The best kinds of demos for this show are the ones where you just get in there, you play a game for a little bit, you see how you feel about it, and then you move on to the next one. So, thank you for watching. I'm sorry about no Guilty Gear tonight for those who were looking forward to it. We'll just do that next week on next week's Friday stream. Hopefully, we'll get some more viewers for that, and then I'll feel more inclined to do that. But I do really want to play Guilty Gear. I've had this for a while. It's just, you know, I don't want to waste that stream on a night where I'm not really feeling 100%, and that we don't have a lot of viewers anyways, because I feel like it's going to be good to play that with people who will kick my ass. So thank you for tuning in. Tomorrow will be F-Zero and maybe some Yakuza. We'll see. But F-Zero for sure tomorrow. Other than that, I'm not really too sure. Sunday will be Pixel Pulse. Probably won't stream Gabriel Surge after Pixel Pulse, but you never know. We'll see. And other than that, we got a couple more streams left of Undertale, maybe one or two of the Pacifist run. Then we need to do the Genocide run. So a little bit more of Undertale left. And Yakuza is also within a few streams of finishing. So if you're not into the main CSR at the current moment, there will be new games soon. And if you haven't seen, there is a poll still ongoing on the Discord that you can vote for what begins after Undertale concludes. I haven't looked at it in a bit. I want to say one game is leading substantially right now. Oh, Discord is installing 16 updates.
Okay, that's fine.
How about you open Discord? I don't need the updates right now. I just want to see how my poll is doing. And then I want to leave so I can eat. chat votes. Oh my god, Discord's being so laggy. Okay, right now, the leading... ironic that I should have talked so much about about Kingdom Hearts, because I didn't realize it. That's what's winning the poll right now. Shit. Well, I mean, if that's what wins, that's what wins. It's not like I don't want to play Kingdom Hearts. I already bought the games, right? So, but all right, you guys have a good... night, day, whatever time it is, maybe for you. It is late night for me, but maybe it's early morning if you're from Europe. Enjoy your weekend, and remember, Picross is pretty good.